How to use an electroscope to detect the presence of charge. Like earlier said, we use an electroscope to detect the presence of charge on the body. This tutorial serves to show how this is done. This is Kisembo Academy, and thanks for tuning in. So we shall simply follow this table and we'll look at the observation and the sign of the charge that should be after making that observation. Let's look at this diagram here. This is the cap of a gold leaf electroscope. This is it's called the brass cap. This is the brass plate, the brass rod, the brass plate, and the gold leaf. This is a positively charged gold leaf electroscope. Now, let us introduce a body on top. If we introduced a body on top of this gold, near the cap of this gold leaf electroscope, a positively charged body, what will happen? Because this is a positively charged body, it means that it is going to attract negative charges from down here up there. So when these negative charges are attracted to come up here, it means that there is going to be an excess of positive charges down there. And the excess of positive charges down here is what is going to cause an increase in divergence. And so it means that if we are having a positively charged gold leaf electroscope with this kind of divergence, then we introduce a body and the observation is such that there's an increase in divergence, then it would mean that the body that will have been introduced will be the same charge as the gold leaf, which is positive. So that is what happens for the case of a positive charge. If we are having a negatively charged gold leaf electroscope and we attempted to introduce a body on top that is also negatively charged, what will happen? This negatively charged rod is going to repel negative charges that are on top here to come down here. So it means that the negative charges upon being repelled will create an excess of negative charges at the brass plate and at the gold leaf, and this will cause an increase in divergence. So that means that if you're having a negatively charged gold leaf electroscope like this one, and you introduced a body near the cap, and it is such that, and what happens, oh, the observation is that there's an increase in divergence, then that would mean that the body that has been introduced at the cap of the gold leaf has got the same charge as the gold leaf electroscope, and that explains our first table. Our first table is saying that an increase in divergence, if that is the observation, it would mean that the sign of the charge of the body that has been introduced is the same as that on that electroscope. So now let's examine the second case. At first, we are having a negatively charged gold leaf electroscope. So we introduce a body that is not negatively charged, but positively charged. What happens? When we introduce a positively charged body, these positive charges are going to attract the electrons from down here. So it means that the electrons that were formerly here are going to be attracted to come and concentrate up here by this positive charge. So when that happens, it would cause the divergence of this leaf to drop. And so what does that mean? It means that if you're having a negatively charged gold leaf electroscope and you introduce a body whose charge you do not know on top, and the observation is such that the divergence of this gold leaf drops, it would mean that that body has got a positive. If the gold leaf is negative, it means the body is positively charged, like I have explained. Likewise, looking at a positively charged gold leaf electroscope, it is positively charged, the brass plate is positive, the gold leaf is also positively charged. But if you are to introduce a body at its top, a negatively charged body is introduced at its top, the divergence of this leaf is going to decrease. Why? Because when you introduce a negatively charged body at the top, the negative charges that are at the cap are going to be repelled towards, away from this place. So they will be repelled towards the brass plate and the gold leaf. So since originally down here they were predominantly positive charges, when the negative charges that are on top are repelled downwards, they are going to neutralize the positives that are there. And when they are neutralized, it means that the divergence of that gold leaf will be decreased. So what does that mean? It means that if you're having a positively charged gold leaf electroscope and you introduce a body whose charge you do not know, and the observation you make is that the divergence decreases, then you just know that whatever body you have introduced there has got a sign or a charge whose sign is opposite the sign of the gold leaf electroscope. And that explains our second assertion, that a decrease in divergence means that the sign of the charge that is on top of the cup is the opposite sign as that on the electroscope. This brings us to the end of this video. Please don't forget to comment below or hit that like button. Someone out there may like to watch this tutorial. Don't forget to share. Otherwise, for more videos, simply subscribe to this channel. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rwanga Kuramya.